is an entrepreneur in himself or herself. But one thing which I have noticed in my previous institution and here also with regard to the management faculty, sorry, management students, there is slight erosion of the value system. So I request all of you to please maintain and imbibe the value system. Reason being, the modern business does not work in an ethical environment, does not work in unethical environment. Work this ethics comes at the time. When work with ethical orientation, only then people can aspire to be on the higher ladder. You might have a specific subject on business ethics. It is not only mere passing subject. It has the value system. But if I go beyond that, your own curriculum that speaks volumes about the augmentation of the knowledge, and knowledge comes at the bottom of the pyramid. If we have knowledge, we can think of our attitude for its transformation in skills, which is the requirement of the new world, entrepreneurship. Majority of the students in management stream, they come with high aim of being CEO. But once they are asked, what do you want to do in your life? Many of them may say, ki aksar abhi socha nahi hai. Friends, it is high time. Decide about your career path. If you not decide as of now, it may be very difficult for you to choose a path in your future. It will be interesting business, the environment in which we are working or we have to work. That is very dynamic. And in a philosophical manner, you cannot step twice in the same running water. The moment you try to step twice, the water will be gone. I do honor and welcome the students who are sitting on the back benches. Perhaps they are the very sacred follower of our President Abdul Kalam, who has said, you will find the best talent on the last benches of the class. So I think the best talent is there, but sir, you can transform, you can change as per the situation. You can come in the forward seats because ultimately you don't want, you cannot drive while sitting on the back seat. You have to come on the forefront to drive any train or car or an engine. I wish you all the very best in your future endeavors. All the best. Please attend the classes regularly. Actually, मुझे कहना पड़ रहा है, मैं आपको बता दूँ, जो मेरे टीचर साथी बैठे हैं मैनेजर फैकल्टी के, उनके लिए मैं बता दूँ, अब तक मैं करीब 1.5 महीने में इन साल में 2 बार चक्कर लगाए गया हूँ, किसी को नहीं पता है. मैं अपनी प्राइवेट गाड़ी से आया था, क्योंकि वहां मेरा आना जाना वहां पर लगा रखा, कभी वायरा के लिए, कभी आप लोगों से इंटरेक्शन के लिए. तो ना बेड हैबिट्स डाई हार्ड, इंसान में आने जाने की आदत इतनी जल्दी नहीं बढ़ेगी. मैं आता लगाता रहूंगा, पैदल आऊंगा या प्राइवेट गाड़ी से आऊंगा वो मुझे मालूम है, लेकिन मैं विजिट इंसान क्लासेस जो होनी चाहिए थी, जितना नंबर हमारा स्टूडेंट्स का है उससे कम लगी हुई थी. माई हम्बल रिक्वेस्ट टू ऑल ऑफ यू, my budding friends, budding manager, please attend the class, because class is the only platform where you can learn knowledge and you can develop your attitude and you can transform them into skill. Thank you one and all.
So it is basically to aspect the entrepreneurs doing international business. As Dr. Pinyas, I completely agree with him. Today, nothing but an Indian business. Today, business when you do, it is a global business. Whether you do in India or abroad, your customer can be anywhere in the world. There is nothing but you have a customer basically who is there in Haryana or Delhi. I don't think any business segment considered the customer in that narrow bandwidth. So, it is an international business in true sense, whatever you do. Today is the era where India is doing in various fronts very different. You must be feel proud that in this constrained environment of the whole world, Indian economy is the most stable economy. Once again, I repeat, Indian economy is the most stable economy. Our GDP is growing one of the strongest growth. So this is the right time to do something. Not by India, by the Indians. And this is the time for us, our government is also promoting that Indians should do something very good for themselves, which in turn excellent for the country. And to make it happen, don't have a preset notion of a employee, change it to an employer. When you are an employer, you can employ lots of your friends. It's a multiple and a multiplier impact. You not only create a job for you, but you create a job for many others. And today, most of you must have seen that too many entrepreneurship activities are also started in India with offering. Initially, if you see very rudimentary data, where you say that in contact there are 5,000 entrepreneurs there in the other side, you have around 50-60 entrepreneurs in India, which is a meager number. But you know, the most of the biggest company in the world, their R&D centers are in India. So there are lots of fallacy happened and happening around. So most of the activities are also happening, even when there is automobile R&D, whether it is an IT related R&D, whether it is some other related R&D, even why not some manufacturing, which I am not talking about automotive only. So it's happening in India. So there is enough intellectual base. Only we have to make ourselves to strong believer. Believe on yourself and start respecting yourself. You can do it. You have the potential. And we are here to make it happen. If it is still failing, it is not only your failure, it is our failure too. So in this context, I will give some examples of what we have done just your next door, just in the other side, and what way it can help all of us. Because we as an IIM, and it's for national importance, we cannot do something for our exclusively for us or exclusively for someone else. We have a national responsibility. That is our fundamental role. So we have started our incubation or entrepreneurship shell 2 years back as a thought process. But after a couple of months or maybe a couple of months times, we have started moving rapidly. And we are here today in a significant junction. I tell you some of the incidents or some of the facts which give you why it has happened. So we have started the incubation centers assuming that we will create something, a vibrant, enabling system which will support this whole northern region. Ambitious thought. Always think for self, let us do something for us. But we have started thinking that let us do something as an enabler. Where suddenly we do for our own, but also try to see if anyone is being nearby, can collaborate, can coordinate and create a collaborative system as an incubation center. To make it happen, you have enough entrepreneur, successful entrepreneur became the mentor of our entrepreneurship side. And he became very rich knowledge-wise, very soon. Then one of our commercial hub, the Carbon Oil, they found that there is lots of potential in them, and they granted $1 million to us as a seed money. For this is to be used as a seed money. This is to be used as a seed money for the incubators, not by us. So we cannot touch that. So this will be used by the incubators as a seed money, because they have to start from somewhere, zero. Where is the money for them? So that's how it is. Now the government of India, as Honorable Prime Minister Narendra Modi has started his startup, stand-up and all these things, that has continued them to identify few, very few institutes in India to start technical business incubators or incubation centers as a enabling zone. And there's a lots of retailing, and there's a lots of presentations was happened in January, month of January, IIM or whatever. And finally they shortlisted very few. We are one of them. So in the last week, as then in Ministry of Energy, to have a final discussions. So we had a lot of other partners like IIC Bangalore, one or two other lines, then IITs, who are also being partnering in this particular joint activity by Government of India. So we have discussed our whole road plan, and it is being approved, and government is also granting a couple of crore rupees for the same. To making these things happen, we are also working hard. Our set of faculty and the students are working day and night to see that these incubation centers should make it a great success. We have conducted multiple business plan competitions. We have got a great success, and a couple of them are being shortlisted. They are not only they are in Rohtak, but somewhere else. And of late, couple of interesting business plan also being submitted individually by some of the local peoples, around 7 or 8. Obviously, we have a strong procedure of filtering them through a mentorship process. We don't know who will get selected, maybe one of them can be our local person. And once you get the selections, obviously we follow our own things. And to make this further shape up, our incubation centers was opened, officially inaugurated on 18th of January by none other than Mr. Amitabh Kant, the secretary of DIPT, who is one of the strong drivers on behalf of the Government of India for this entrepreneurship. And we have also published a policy document, which is the most important part of the any incubation center success. Everything has to be spelled out with a great details. Who will do it what? Who can do what? How to do it? What not to be done? Everything should be spelled out. Including when you occupy a space, what is your rent for each and everything. So our procedural document is also being released in the same place in November 23rd by Dr. Pillai, who is one of the renowned missile scientists of India. So we have things are in place, we have document is in place, we are working in place, and of late we have added one more feature, that the backward community, the backward plus forum, or the ministry backward plus segment, which we call it, I forget the name, National Backwardness Finance and Development Corporation, which is under the coming under the Ministry of Justice in Power, Empowerment, they have surrendered NU with us with an objective to make that backward community entrepreneur friendly, not to give them job, to make them entrepreneur. We are taking the challenge. We along with them will try to make a select area. Some of them settled in Haryana, select some of the areas in other places and see how we can empower them to become entrepreneur rather than a job seeker. They have also given enough support for that. They are going to give us continuous support to us. What I am talking is that is only an energy is required with you. The ample opportunity is here, not only with us, even some other places. The surrounding environment, like government, different government bodies, are really empowered to make it happen, because that's how we can solve the problem of a huge country like India, not by creating jobs, but let people create jobs for themselves. And I think only one thing is required, that all of us who are in this auditorium are learned or acquiring knowledge to become a learned person. Hence, by doing so, all of us have the potential. The only thing is that have the right energy. I can do it. I think with this, I can only say that have a self-belief that I am one of the potential person who knows the subject, who knows the thing. Now have only create our thought process, how to make it happen, is something I feel is very interesting. We assure you, all of us are with you to see that you are successful, and your success is our success, and it is Indian success. Thank you.
Overall, I see that people don't take personal responsibilities in India. They don't. There is no accountability. By and large, there is gross incompetence. That is the reality. Moreover, there is a prevalence of unethical behavior. There is a lack of civic sense and disregard for law and order. We as Indians see every problem as a political problem and seek the solution as a political solution to those problems. It ain't going to work in India. If you think the government is going to solve your problems, you are on the wrong path. You as individuals have to take the responsibility. So please grow up. You haven't grown up yet. You don't know what the world is like. You live in your own dreams, promoted by Bollywood, and you think you are the best out there. You are not. You have to wake up to the reality. Number two, I see there is a system-related problems. There are no measures of performance, no monitoring of those performances, no evaluations. The arcane processes are observed all the time. There are no adequate resources to support those systems. There are no robust systems. And there is a political interference in every system you come across. That system is not going to work either. As it is said, losers have goals. Winners have the systems. Has it ever occurred to you as to why countries like the United States or England, that have very tiny proportion of populations of India, are the world powers? What are they doing right that we cannot, so that we also can be a global power. Did it ever occur to you that? Did it ever you wondered as to what is right with them? And how could we implement that in our country? I seriously doubt that we took that discussion to heart. Dr. Punia this morning said, he's urging you students to attend the classes. He was touching the surface. I think there's something seriously going on in our educational institutions that we're trying to be truthful about. Here's what is going on. There are 700 universities in India. None of them ranks in top 200 in the world. It's not me who is saying it. It is Pranab Mukherjee, the president of India, who said that. Did it ever occur to us as to why? Even with all the resources given by the government to these universities, we cannot compete. Our institutions cannot rank high in the world. Did it ever occur to you that as students, you don't take your studies seriously? You are here because the education is free, and maybe because your parents don't want to be hanging around in the homes. So you show up at the classrooms. You aren't serious about your studies. And if you are not serious about your studies, if you are not serious about your future, who else will? Ask that question. If you are serious about yourself, are you taking it seriously or not? Now about entrepreneurs. Honestly, entrepreneurship requires lots out of individuals. And whatever interaction I had at IIMs and IITs occasionally, I noticed that we're not challenging our students enough. Our expectations are very low. And with those low expectations, we are going to get a low quality youth coming out of our educational institutions also. We're not testing our students, we're not testing them to the best abilities that they have. We have to find a way to challenge our youth, to expect the very best out of them. We aren't doing that. To be an entrepreneur, you have to learn to accept failures. We don't have a concept about what failure is like. As parents, we raise our children like puppies, like the God-given gift, and we think that they will succeed in the society overnight. It doesn't happen that way. Individuals have to test what failure is. That's when the best comes out of that individual. We have not tested that. You will have to learn what failure is like. Failure is a good teacher, and you have to have the ability to learn from it, to grow up as an adult. That's extremely important. I see that happen in other countries, other cultures. Unfortunately, our culture does not accept failure. And the society that has no tolerance for failure is not going to succeed. You know why? Because success is not an event, but it's a process. And failure is a part of that process. Failure is going to happen, but you experiment. If you don't experiment, you are not going to succeed. You can maintain a status quo. Japanese or Chinese can make the same product rather differently. But they are not going to come out with innovative products because this culture does not accept failures. And we are in the same boat. We have to learn to accept failure. Learn that failure teaches you a whole lot. Other things that's expected of an entrepreneur is being flexible. You have to be extremely flexible. There is no optimal solution to anything. You know, in the academia, we promote this myth that there is an optimal solution to anything. In real life, there is no optimal solution. There is only a feasible solution. You have to be flexible based on the environment. There are so many variables that change on the time, and you have to be willing to accept them. You have to have leadership skills. Motivate people to be under you. You have your critical thinking abilities, mathematical reasoning. You have to be able to have communication skills, oral and written communications. And above all, be willing to work hard, really hard. I don't see that in my students in India, my colleagues, the universities that I go and talk to. My first question to students always is, how many hours a week do you study? outside the classroom. And guess what I get? Oh, about 5 hours a week. And you know what? I could tell them, your competition in the world, they study about 30 to 35 hours a week. Where are you? Wake up. Then we need to accept that. This is your competition. Your competition is not India. It's not Delhi or Mumbai or Chennai. It's a global world coming together. And if you really want to succeed, you want to make a mark, you want to change the society, demand the very best of yourself. Take that responsibility and please grow up. Thank you.
Today, we are honored to welcome our chief speaker, Dr. Amiya Chandra, ITS joined BGFT. Dr. Chandra have been trained in Indian Institute of Foreign Trade and have handled imports and exports policy and procedures as an officer since 1989. Appointed as the lead speaker and motivator of Niryat Bandhu scheme, sir has also handled WTO, anti-dumping and anti-subsidies issues. Dr. Chandra has an experience of working in the Ministry of Labour, Ministry of Parliamentary Affairs, Ministry of Statistics and Programme Implementations. In addition, he has also looked after the central zone of Delhi as the deputy commissioner and was also the assessor and collector of property tax of entire Delhi. Sir has also served as a PS to Minister of State, Prime Minister's Office, and PS to MOS Labour, PS to MOS Youth Affairs and Sports, and as a Joint Development Commissioner, Handlooms and Senior Director, Crafts Museum, Ministry of Textiles. Along with this, Dr. Chandra has presented papers and delivered lectures on doing business with Central Asia to almost all business schools in Delhi, universities in India as well as abroad. We welcome you to today's seminar, sir. The stage is yours.
Good morning. I hope you are absolutely awake.
Yes, sir.
I was making this presentation on Valentine's Day. Because I thought I love this job. And I thought I should begin my presentation. The aim of my being here is to tell you to always fall in love with something which you want. Not something which your parents want, not something which Dr. Amiya Chandra wants, not something which Dr. Damodar wants. Alright? You know who is he? He is one of the leading cardiologists of the world. And he said, I love medicine. And I love to be there where I am. You know Harsha Bhogle?
Yes, sir.
He is a product of IIM Ahmedabad. You know that?
Yes, sir.
What did he say? Most entertainment is an escape from reality. And sports is an escape into reality. So he wants that I do not want to escape away from reality. I want to skip into reality, may it not be that way, and that's why I love this. He did not pursue the normal business management career. He became a sports commentator and it was registered by his family. But look where he is. Why? Because he loved being a commentator. Alright? You know him? Who is he? Sanjeev Kapoor. And what did he say? His punchline was, I love cooking. When my son came and said that he wants to do cooking, he's very young right now, he just gone into college. I said, if you love cooking, please go ahead. Be a good chef. And have a strong educational background. But this does not mean that you should not pursue what you love to be. You know who is he? Chetan Bhagat, product of IIM Ahmedabad. What did he say? He said, write what you love what you write. And you know what Chetan Bhagat is today? I followed my heart. You know, it's me, Charles Soria. He said, I love beautiful architecture, buildings, and I want to be there. He's no more, but he taught us what beauty in architecture is. Mallika Sarabhai, I am Ahmedabad. I dance to live, I dance to breathe, I dance to be free, I dance to be me. Live, love, dance. She loved to be a dancer. She was a product of IIM Ahmedabad. You know him, you know Dham. He has invented Pentium, product of IIT. And he says today Pentium is the basic of computer. I love engineering. That's why I am here. Ramchandra Guha, product of IIM Calcutta, he is a noted historian today. He was not taught history in IIM Calcutta, but his heart lied to be a noted historian. Got his education, became a historian. Ram Gaitanani and our solicitor, ex-solicitor general of India, he said, I breathe law. I think of law. I only argue from the legal point of view because I love being a legal man. Neela Madhav Pai, I am Bangalore, filmmaker, director, screenwriter. He was rejected earlier. His book was not published. Today he is credited with starting the children movement in Indian cinema. And he is a product of IIM Bangalore. You know this Rakesh Jhunjhunwala, one of the 50 richest man, what Harshad Mehta used to be there. He is supposed to be 10 times bigger than Harshad Mehta. And what did he say? No, but in the ethical way. And what did he say? He said, I stand corrected. And he said, I love training. He is one of the person who dictates what should happen in the stock market. Because he thinks that my art, many of you might love football. Many of you might love to play chess. And that's your love. Amish Patiya in Calcutta. What did he do? He took up writing and wrote Shiva Trilogy. What did he say? He said, I was preparing for the exam. I saw a dream for IIM exam that Shiva came to me and said, start writing. So he made a fictitious character, Shiva, and wrote Trilogy. That's it today. In fact, my young son, he has finished all three volumes. And he says, what a man he is. You know him? Sidhin Wadhukut, I am Ahmedabad blogger. He has started blog. He loves blogging. And he's a master in blogging. You know that Salim Sethi, I am Ahmedabad, what has he done? He has started microfinancing. And he says that my aim is to reach the poorest of the poor. He helps them. He helps their projects. And he's a man who is now Secretary General of Amnesty International. He is from IIM Ahmedabad. You know, Vijay Mahajan, IIM Ahmedabad, social entrepreneur. He has set up Pradhan, he has set up Vita Soko and Basics, and he helps again the poorest of the poor. He has lived, he has just resigned from his production job, and he is reaching out and listening to the most downtrodden of the society. You know, I can have many. Gaurav Dagonkar, IIM Ahmedabad. You know, but the beauty why I am telling you about this person, when he started his music today, is roaming throughout India and the world. He used his IIM training and training as a business manager to sell off his projects. And he says that his degree actually helped him to negotiate the deal with his sponsors. He got while traveling throughout the world. You know, our ex-president has said a beautiful word. In fact, somebody was telling from here, learning gives creativity. Creativity leads to thinking. Thinking provides knowledge, and knowledge makes you great. That's why I'm saying, whatever love you want to pursue, must have a good learning, must have a strong academic background, because that will propel you to give creativity. In fact, I was just watching the CNN just few days back, and that's where from I am starting to film Chalati, he is a filmmaker. And that says, the United States of America, where he stated, 9% of Indians are there who have 20% of the postgraduate colleges, their percentages. Most of the Indians in USA are considered leaving far behind any other race. And statistics was in terms of income, statistics was in terms of education, statistics was in terms of their deployment in R&D. And then they said, that's not that India is a mighty race, but given the opportunity, they can excel themselves. So if the presentation by one of my colleagues gave you any thing that you cannot do it, I must assure you that you have already done it. And my presentation is here to say that you can do it. I will set up my presentation with small movies, because 1 minute, 2 minutes, because that will actually show you what I am trying to say. I can motivate few of you to start your own business and export, I think my purpose is successful. And I must tell you that I have a strong reason to feel that you can do good business in India and you can do good business abroad, contrary to what may be popular perception. That's why I say that you must say I love export. You know, there was a guy called Keel McDonald in the US. And Keel McDonald in 2007 thought that I must own up a house. And what did he do? He said, from where should I begin? So he wrote on the computer that there is a red paper clip lying next to me on my table. I want to exchange it with you and I want to ultimately succeed in owning up a house. Most of the people thought, what a joke. How can you own up a house by exchanging a red paper clip? So he wrote that, in exchange wherever you are, I'm willing to come and exchange this red paper clip. So what did he do? First time he get a fish shaped pen in Michigan. He went there, he exchanged that red paper clip with a fish shaped pen. Then he got a stove, which was very old stove, which he exchanged that stove. Then he got, in exchange for the stove, a Honda set generator, which was 2-3 years old. He exchanged that. Then he got a scooter. Then he got a singing contract. Then he got house on rent for 2 years. Then he got a date, Alice Cooper, and a disc-shaped globe. Then that he exchanged with a role in a film called Dona on Demand, which was never made. And finally, he got a house. Now, in this entire journey, from a red paper clip to owning up a house, there were two things which were very important. One is that he had a vision, second that he had a commitment. And I want to imbibe those vision on those commitments. India may be a bad state, there may not be a structure here, there may not be a sound working environment here, the students may not be paying too much of attention to the classes. But I think we all can pull up and do that miracle. We have done it miracle throughout the world. And my whole objective is to tell you how to go about it. He, McDonald, had a need of a house. He had an idea how to go about it. He had a vision that this is how he would proceed. He identified this opportunity. He had a commitment to do that. He had adaptability and flexibility. He traveled there and bought that. He built a story around it. He had a belief that he can do it. He innovated himself in many ways. He did his marketing on the internet. Today, this is one of the case studies at Harvard Business School. He built up human relationships. When his house was built, he brought everybody there. And they are a part of his. He traveled throughout the US. He had an experience in the entire thing. He was never on the wrong side of the law while doing it. And many more. These all are the things which will transform you as a student, law student, to a successful businessman. Because these are important traits which I have mentioned here to be a successful businessman. Here. Coming very briefly, what is international trade? You know, international trade is that transaction of goods and services when it crosses the boundary and foreign exchange comes here. I had a very important case of Air India. In Air India, they had done services abroad, but the money had not come to India. So the case was not proceeded because they said they cannot be considered exports till the foreign exchange and remittances come to India. So, in fact, Professor Damodar has rightly said, we have been doing badly in exports right now. So is the entire world. But right now, our month-to-month performance and decline, performance and decline has been seen. Starting from January, you can see that the growth is all negative. 10%, 7%, 11%, 12%, 13%, 7%, 12%, 12%, 11%. Till this period, in 2015, we have gone all negative. Okay, tell me one thing. In this Valentine day, rose was very costly. 50 rupees? 80 rupees? Did you still buy some of you the roses? None of you bought roses? Some of you bought roses? Alright. That means that even if roses become 50 rupees, 100 rupees, 200 rupees, you will earn more still buy roses. Isn't it? That's important. The export is declining. The world over there is declining. Will you stop exporting? You will not stop exporting. Then how to recover this? I am going to tell you in the other slide. You know, internationally, we have already thought, we have always thought that our trade is to develop countries, that is USA, Japan, European Union. The World Trade Organization statistics shows that we are shifting towards the concept of what we call economic narcissism. Who was narcissist? Who was narcissist? अच्छा आपको एक बात बताइए सुबह सुबह उठ के आईना देखते हैं कितने लोग आईना देखते हैं अरे हाथ उठाइए नहीं देखते हैं तो देखना शुरू कीजिए आईना देख के क्या बोल रहा है आई एम मोस्ट हैंडसम मैन बट आई एम मोस्ट ब्यूटीफुल वुमन अगर आप अपने आप को रिस्पेक्ट नहीं कीजिएगा तो दूसरा कैसे आपको रिस्पेक्ट करेगा इजंट इट ऑलराइट सो जगदीश नंदन भागवती सेज दैट द ट्रेड इज मूविंग टुवर्ड्स रीजनल नार्सिसिज्म व्हाट इज रीजनल नार्सिसिज्म SAC, SACTA, EU, NAFTA, जो SAC के ब्लॉक्स है वहां पे ट्रेड बढ़ रहा है सो द ट्रेड बिटवीन डेवलप्ड कंट्रीज डिक्लाइनिंग इन टर्म्स ऑफ परसेंटेज एंड ट्रेड बिटवीन डेवलपिंग कंट्रीज इज ऑन इंक्रीज दैट इज पॉइंट नंबर वन सो यू कैन सी दैट एशिया 46% वॉज द ट्रेड इन 2003 इट हैज गॉन टू 49% एंड डायरेक्शन इज मूविंग टुवर्ड्स सदर्न कंट्रीज Share of Asia, Africa, and Latin America, is going on increase. So the future is towards developing countries. So if you think that you are going to do business only with America or EU, change your priority. That's point number one. Point number two, this is the slide which shows that with the advanced economies, trade is declining. With emerging markets and East industrializing countries, the trade is on increase. That is what. The second point which I'm trying to say is that you can see that Saudi Arabia, the trade is second highest after China, that is in terms of import and in terms of exports. Why Saudi Arabia? Sorry? Because of two reasons. One reason. One is that of course it's an oil country, it has good purchasing capacity. Second is that this is a source and hub of transshipment. Why transshipment? Achha, aapke ghar mein kabhi maa aur father ke beech jhagda hota hai to kya hota hai? जो बच्चे होते हैं वो मैसेंजर हो जाते हैं ना पापा से बोल दो मम्मी से बोल दो इंडिया पाकिस्तान के बीच झगड़ा है तो सारे ट्रेड सऊदी अरेबिया थ्रू पाकिस्तान जा रहे हैं यू सी ऑल द मूवीज पाकिस्तानी टीवी दिस इज शाहरुख खान विच इज फ्रॉम सऊदी अरेबिया सो द ट्रेड विच इज गोइंग फ्रॉम इंडिया टू पाकिस्तान इज ऑल्सो शिफ्ट थ्रू सऊदी अरेबिया एंड ऑफकोर्स इट्स developed port from there, lots of transshipment happens. So the trade going to Saudi Arabia is not exactly for Saudi Arabia, it's happening throughout the world also. These are the top import items, these are the top export items, and you can see trade in services is going high compared to the trade in manufacturing capacity. Okay, I'm just skipping this. But important point which I want to show is that in India, if you see, the trade in goods is declining and trade in services is on increase. The second point I would like to say that all those who are in IT or who are in services, they have a strong future as far as trade is concerned. These are the hurdles. He has pointed out bad news comes in terms of the herd mentality. Professor Damodar has rightly said that we follow the herd mentality. Tum kya kar rahe ho? Tum ye business kar rahe ho? Hum bhi wahi business karenge. Second issue is that we have pessimism. Pessimism was reflected. Pessimism is there. We as a nation cannot do it. Third is that we have an archaic attitude. Yes, I keep pointing out things which are pre-British period, many things still even now. There is a chalta hai, that chalta hai, and there is an obsession that China, West, and US are always better than us. I just want to tell you that these are the hurdles. These are not blockages. These are the hurdles, and if we need to, we can always cross the hurdle. How? I am going to show you how. I'll come to the bad news now. In terms of compliances, that is what we are trying to make, and in terms of consistency, we have 186th position in the world. Sustainability, energy sustainability, we are 115 out of 129 countries. Pollution, 155 out of 178 countries. Productivity, we are at the bottom of the segment. Customer service, 186 out of 189. Lead time, 95, time between what you make and how it reaches. Quality, very low quality. Ease of doing business, 130 out of 189. Incidentally, they have improved from 142. Worker attrition, what is worker attrition? We treat workers as a servant. like a needle. If it's broken, we remove the needle. If the worker goes home, we just say that bye-bye. In all over the world, the workers are retained and they are trained. In India, only 16% of the firms offer them services. 92% of the workers are offered services in China, 42% in South Korea, and all the countries which provide in-house training, the productivity is high, 23 to 28%, and that interest. You know, somebody asked me why there is no vision for the exports. I say my two eyes are aching. One eye is interest rate, other eye is infrastructure. So two eyes are basically aching. These are the ease of doing business, how we have moved up. Starting a business, in fact, the statistics at least show that we have moved by 9 ranks, and that's how we have moved from 142 to 130. Alright, we have an obsession with China, and we are blaming China for capturing India market, and we are also trying to always duplicate China. We always say that if we depreciate the money, possibly our exports will go up. I want to say to you that this is no solution. Because our even buyer knows that what is the value of rupees today, and we are to be blamed, but the government is not willing to be blamed. After all, we say, movie dekhi hai Hobbit. Aapne dekhi hai Hobbit. देखिए हम लोग के जमाने की मूवी होती थी बॉबी में एक गाना था अरुणाई रानी वो गाना था फंसा दैट इज नोन एज फंसा सिंड्रोम डू यू नो व्हाट इज आवर रैंक इन द वर्ल्ड इन प्रोड्यूसिंग सैंपल इन क्वालिटी वाइज एनी गेस वाइल्ड गेस सॉरी वाइल्ड गेस 50 100 186 250, we are number one in the world. We are number one in the world as far as making sample is concerned. And do you know what we are like in producing counter sample? And these are international studies. We are number three in the world. Do you know what is counter sample? The buyer asks for the sample once again, once you are given. And do you know what is our rank in the world when we actually make delivery of the goods? We are 186. So right from number 1, we go to 186 by the time we deliver it. So this is what we call it Fasa syndrome. I have got you. Once the buyer gives the order, then the roads are bad, shipments are not there, workers have run away, buffalo is sick. We have got all kinds of excuses. And we develop what we call sourcing fatigue. We have to come out of that sourcing fatigue. And delivering this lecture to the most prominent people in India. That's why I'm giving you the concept how we can come out and create what Professor Damodar said, a system. System can be created when there is a consistency, when we are world number one in producing sample, we do not sit down to 186 in the world. We have to build up a system. How will we build up a system? That also I'm going to explain. In fact, that's why I said my task is much easier because I'm going to tell you how the system is to be built. This is in the beginning everything, yes, yes, yes. Then the second concept of the system which he has pointed out. Atithi Devo Bhava, Boss Devo Bhava. You know what is Boss Devo Bhava? In India, every decision is taken by the boss. So what should be the sanitation level, how the order should be placed, how we should discuss with the overseas buyer, how there should be marketing, what should be the government liaison, every decision is taken by the boss. And as a counter to this, what we do is that when we call a foreign buyer, we say that boss se baat karo. Because we believe in the boss culture. Whereas throughout the world, the professionalism is given importance. So you have a floor manager, you have a shop manager, you have a liaison officer, and he is in charge of the entire team. Boss does not take the decision. So you as a management students, if you are a boss or you are working in an MNC or some position, you have to say that I am responsible. And boss is not the one who will take all the decisions. So we have to build a system where boss Devo Nama culture is not there. You know, whenever there is a social auditing, we get an order from US where social auditing is compulsory, we immediately do social auditing. No child labor, working hours are fine, hygienic conditions are maintained, but wherever that compulsion is not there, we do not go for social auditing. Let's make it a habit of making the social auditing for ourselves, because these are the things which pay in the long run. He has pointed out about the threat. There are many threats. There are competitors gaining market share on the strength of volume and price, China. Competitors aging out on the strength of quality, EU market, Germany. Better terms of trade by competing countries, Vietnam, Bangladesh. Better packaging, many countries have evolved. Stricter international standard, barcoding. International campaign against China and social standard, we are improving out. However, how can we, you know, why I said this picture was of Shiva and Shakti. We actually do not know whether we should be Shiva or we should be Shakti. I was going to the handloom sector, they were not too sure that they should go to the power loom or they should remain in handloom. How can you be Valli one once you have decided you are Shiva Valli in increased and better technology support and R&D facility in competing countries? Growing environmental concern in the country affecting supply of raw material. These all are the problems with us. Lack of coordination between institutions, increased competition among indigenous groups, excessive reliance on state incentive props. Government of India must do everything. That is the one thing which I have been hearing. You know, Winston Churchill has said something, and that's what I am quoting. A pessimist sees the difficulty in every opportunity. An optimist sees the opportunity in every difficulty. Are you a pessimist or an optimist? So, let's get along. Steve Jobs came on a rise. In fact, he spoke about the failure. And he said that failure, how do we learn from the failure? I'll show you a very small slide of the failure. Right slide, Swati. Just run the slide. Run the slide. And this is the slide. This is he gave the jump to Steve Jobs and 25 million.
After being cut from his high school basketball team, he went home, locked himself in his room, and cried. He wasn't able to speak until he was almost 4 years old, and his teachers said he would never amount to much. Was demoted from her job as a news anchor because she wasn't fit for television. Fired from a newspaper for lacking imagination and having no original ideas. At age 11, he was cut from his team after being diagnosed with a growth hormone deficiency, which made him smaller in stature than most kids his age. At 30 years old, he was left devastated and depressed after being unceremoniously removed from the company he started. A high school dropout whose personal struggles with drugs and poverty culminated in an unsuccessful suicide attempt. A teacher told him he was too stupid to learn anything and that he should go into a field where he might succeed by virtue of his pleasant personality. Rejected by Decca Recording Studios, who said, "We don't like their sound, they have no future in show business." His first book was rejected by 27 publishers. His fiancée died, failed in business, had a nervous breakdown, and was defeated in 8 elections. If you've never failed, you've never tried anything new.
I want all of you to be that Amitabh Bachchan. Start, create your own path. In fact, your wife's answer, in fact, director, IIM, both of them have started that you have the incubation, you start, set your trend ablaze. I do not want any one of you to be just a person. There has to be a part-time shift. You know, earlier, while you used to do international business, there were just two qualifying criteria. You need to have a price and you need to be delivery on time. What is the winning criteria? You need to have design and services in addition. You cannot win till you have price, delivery, design and services, package of services. So in terms of operations, you have to shift from doing business in all products to a specializing products. From unstructured business to a structured and planned approach, you used to have an emphasis on price. We need to have value to customer approach and a concept of TQM, total quality management. Earlier we used to be unreliable supplier, we used to have hospitality, information gap and unpredictable. We need to be, in terms of services, a reliable supplier, package of services we have to offer, we have to give information to our buyer and we have to be predictable. In terms of marketing and sales, shift has to be from tactics to strategy. This all must have been taught to you, so I'm not dealing in details. Need to have an ecologic focus. Social accounting. From merchandising to marketing, merchant and trading approach to manufacturing marketing approach, from chaos to planning and system, quantity driven to ability driven, buyer driven to market driven, and there has to be a channel focus. In the same way, earlier qualifying criteria used to be obsolete technology, now you need to have good technology and TQM, total quality assurance. You need to have learning organization, clean factory, professional management, high level skills and national and international sourcing. If you do not source from outside, possibly you cannot succeed. Need then the time, earlier you used to say pick up the goods from my factory, you need to have a door to door approach. Rather than transportation, you need to have emphasis on logistics and you have to shift from inbound logistics to timely delivery and speeds. Now, what is the strategy for competitive advantage? In fact, it was very rightly pointed out that in the engineering sector, in the 34 product category, we are not a dominant position even in one product category. And we have to get to establish leadership position in any engineering product category. The reason is that we have a perception of a follower nation. We have to break the perception of the follower nation by shifting to a leading nation. How can it happen? You need to go to a high quality product because they have their own advertisement. You need to choose and attain leadership position at least in some product categories, and you have to recognize the increasing role of standards in global trade. To grow, does India need to follow what China has done? No. Comparison between two countries is obvious, but you cannot follow the China way and you need to have your own perspective because the next to China is China only. I have the common belief that China has priced itself out in the market and customers are fleeing to more competitive country is myth. Costs are rising in China, but they are rising everywhere and the productivity in China is very high, our productivity is low. So we cannot compete China in terms of duplicating China. We cannot, China in fact projected itself by saying that we are factory to West and what we need to be, not factory to West but Germany of the East. Germany of the East means quality product. Germany is known for its quality product. We should adopt a hybrid model but we must adopt a quality product. In fact, while it's on, I will tell you one of the points which I always emphasize wherever I go for giving lecture to the exporting community, there is too much of in-cutting. Suppose aapka competitor 25 rupaye pe de raha hai, aap 20 rupaye pe aa jayenge. And that's why I gave usme lagaiye se usme film pe aa gaya aapko ye bata diya. That's why I gave the film of Flying Geese. Flying Geese is a very important film. Flying Geese, yeah. Yeah. Wisdom of Flying Geese, and that's very important for you. Just look at this film very, very, very carefully.
Thank you.
आज के दिनों में हम लोग जितने लोग इंडिविजुअल रूप से काम करते हैं, अगर ग्रुप की तरह काम करना शुरू करें तो इस की तरह हमेशा इम्पोर्टेंस रहेगा। ये जरूरी नहीं है कि हमारा नाम आगे हो, जरूरी यह है कि हम जिस ऑर्गेनाइजेशन में काम कर रहे हैं उस ऑर्गेनाइजेशन का नाम आगे हो। इसलिए आपने देखा होगा कि बीस में एक बार जो आगे फ्लाई कर रहा है वो थक जाता है, वो पीछे आ जाता है, दूसरा आदमी लीडरशिप ले लेता है, और चूंकि वो अपने विंग्स को फ्लैग करता है उसके चलते कम से कम 30% की एडिशनल बॉयसी उसके पीछे आने वाले बीस को मिलता है। तो हमेशा एक ग्रुप में फ्लाई करने पर बीस को हमेशा फायदा होता है, और एक भी घायल होता है उसको नीचे ले जाते हैं, नीचे ले जाने के बाद जब तक रिकवर नहीं करता है तब तक वो बीस उसी तरह उड़ते रहते हैं, रिकवर करने के बाद बाहर आकर जब ज्वाइन करता है फिर ये ग्रुप आपस में आगे चलने लगता है। हमारे लिए इम्पोर्टेंट है इंडिविजुअल एक्सेलेंस गेन करना, बट हम कितने बड़े लीडर हैं, और अगर आपकी यूनिवर्सिटी जो स्टीम यूनिवर्सिटी के लोग हैं बच्चे हैं, आप जब बिजनेस ज्वाइन करें लीडरशिप प्रोवाइड नहीं किया करेंगे गीज की तरह तो हमारा सारा एफर्ट बेकार रहेगा। सो माई पर्पस हियर इज टू मेक ईच वन ऑफ यू अ लीडर लाइक अ गीज एंड लीड द होल फ्लॉक। लाइक हमारे प्रोफेसर अतानु कह रहे थे कि आप सारे लोगों को एम्प्लॉयमेंट देना है, लीडरशिप प्रोवाइड करना है, और उस लीडरशिप में सारे लोगों को आपके साथ फील करना है, एसोसिएट होना है। दैट्स व्हाई फॉर दैट इट्स इंपॉर्टेंट दैट यू नीड टू हैव अ मल्टीप्लायर इफेक्ट। इफ यू एक्ट लाइक अ गीज वेयर यू हैव 1+1 इट बिकम्स 11, बिकॉज आप आपस में एक्सपीरियंस शेयर करेंगे, आप कैपेसिटी बिल्ड करेंगे, एंड उसके चलते पूरी इंडस्ट्री को फायदा होगा। सो कटिंग कॉस्ट इज नॉट डजंट मीन दैट यू कैप्चर द वैल्यू, लो प्राइस डज नॉट मीन द मार्केट शेयर, आउट ऑफ बॉक्स थिंकिंग मीन्स you do not think about doing business with USA, Europe or China money. You can have lookist policy, you can think Africa, you can think Latin America, and you can have innovative ideas. Follow the path of least resistance. आपको पता है जब World War II के बाद जापान के बिजनेसमैन US मार्केट में इंटर कर रहे थे तो उन्होंने क्या कहा, मतलब मेरी इज वन ऑफ द ग्रुप लाइक BGF की भी है एंड from the organization, Gedi ne apne exporters se pucha, aap kis sector mein jana chahenge? They said, we would like to go in automobile, in IT. They were shocked. They said, in both the sector, America is in a dominant position. They said, no, we will go in these two sectors. What did they do? They went with the bottoms of the strategy. What is the bottoms of the strategy? Path of least resistance or niche market. What they did is that, they started making PC, personal computer, and they went with the Honda. Unhone kaha, are, isme koi value, isme koi problem nahi hai. And then they captured the whole market. When Britain and Germany decided to withdraw from the textile market, what they were doing after industrial revolution, where did they go? They went into the niche market. The designer, the Italian designers, the British designers, they all went where they can go to the niche market and they can have high value added product. So, basic issue is that you have to show and choose the path of least resistance. There is a concept of BTL plus MAMA. What is BTL plus MAMA? You know, and I always tell, I'm just throwing some ideas. When you are making a garment export or leather export, you all go for the segment which is most well known. Fashion designer, young, bache, little healthy. You know, BTL is that big, tall and large plus, size plus. MAMA means, wo kehte hai baby Punjabi mein, baby and baby. Baby is the young lady, baby is the mama. So, you know, this is one 54% of the Canada is BTL plus mama. And we are not targeting this segment. 14% in Australia is BTL plus mama. 3% in UK is BTL plus mama. Worldwide is there. And we are not targeting this market. One of you must take up this market and go for BTL plus mama. In the same manner, we have not set up how to set up a chain of emporium. How can we do the PPP model? How can we have cash and carry mechanism? Some of you might start this mechanism. If you see the Middle East, Jhatka Halal Meat is there. We add in the same way, the leather which is coming out of the halal, we are not putting it halal. And in the Muslim community, there is no branded product which is there. If you see the Muslim people, they have the purchasing power, but they do not have branded product. Some of you can introduce branded product in this because they are importing basically from Italy, Thailand, USA, China, India, Pakistan, Bangladesh. India can have a leading position in this. This is one segment where I have said what you can export to which country. Big three, USA, Japan, you can have pharmaceutical, textiles, agriculture, leather. This is based on DGCIS and other studies of the Ministry of Commerce. But as I pointed out earlier, jab dil kehta hai ki yahan pe export karna hai, wahi export karna hai. But these are the indicative list of big three developed country, Southeast Asia, Northeast Asia, West Asia. These are the products in these countries basically which is going and which there is a great potential and there is a great demand. This is projection 2020. So 4 years henceforth, these products are going to dominate the market. You have to shift from low tech to high tech and you have to innovate in terms of differentiate, outcompete and have the new market. He has pointed out in the R&D, we are lagging behind in the R&D. In the R&D, India is just ahead of some countries like Morocco, Guatemala, Nigeria. We are lagging behind even the countries like Russia, South Africa, and these are the countries which are not developed countries. These are the countries which are called similarly placed countries. So in terms of five input pillars, which we call institution, human capital research, infrastructure, market sophistication and business sophistication, and two output pillar, that is knowledge, technology and creative output, we are lagging behind most of the countries in terms of R&D. Now these are the ideas which I have been throwing to you students. You can help the government in setting up of leather goods park, apparel park, handicraft, SEZ, culture focused exports, and you can have plan and create state of the art, intelligent and complete facility at one place in terms of raw material, make ETP processes, training center, environment friendly, quality control. Most of the government is giving, state government or central government is giving the fund. But creative people are not coming forward for setting up these facilities. Some of you might come forward in setting up these facilities so that whether it's on PPP model or cooperative model or resourceful model where you can involve your creativity in setting up these parks. You know, these are the concepts I'm throwing because these concepts still have not been discussed. And I thought when I'm in the steam gathering, I can throw such concepts where you can work upon. Now, what is an animal bank? You know, in India, more than 5 million male animals are slaughtered because their cost of rearing is very high. For example, buffaloes, for example, male buffaloes, or for example, the bears, you know, ox, that is butchered because cost of rearing is very high. And that's why, because the female buffalo or the cow can give milk, so they are butchered. So what they do is that, गांवों में आपको पता है हरियाणा के लिए किरासन तेल पिला देते हैं सो दैट दे डाई. व्हाई डू यू सेट अप एन एनिमल बैंक? नाउ व्हाट इज द एडवांटेज ऑफ सेटिंग अप एन एनिमल बैंक? एनिमल बैंक सप्लाई एनिमल प्रोवाइड एनिमल पिग्स गोट शीप म्यूल कैमल. इट्स लाइक ए मनी बैंक विद बट विद एनिमल्स एक्सचेंज ऑफ एनिमल इन ह्यूमन एंड एक्सपोर्ट हस्बेंड्री केयर हैज पोटेंशियल टू बिकम इंडिपेंडेंट इंडस्ट्री. आज के दिन जितने स्किल्स जाते हैं सारे स्किल पे चोट लगे होते हैं. एनिमल बैंक में आपके स्किल्स जाएंगे हेल्दी स्किल्स रहेंगे जो आप इंडस्ट्री को भी सप्लाई करते हैं और इन एनिमल्स का 100 काम हो सकता है. द गवर्नमेंट और द लोकल पंचायत और द स्टेट गवर्नमेंट में भी इन्वॉल्व. लेट्स स्टार्ट दिस प्रोजेक्ट. दिस प्रोजेक्ट हैज नेवर बीन थॉट बाय एनीबडी एल्स. इंडिया हैज गिवन द कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ शून्य जीरो. लेट्स हैव एक्सटेंडेड दैट वी विल मेक ए प्रोडक्ट विद जीरो डिफेक्ट. यू नो पीपल लाफ एट इट व्हेन वी से दैट वी विल हैव अ कंसिस्टेंट सप्लाई. Some of the automobile engineering items supplier has given to the world Sundaram Fastener zero defect for last 30 years. And there are many such Indian companies which is there with zero defect. All of you, let's take a vow that whatever quality we are going to have, it will have a zero defect. Power of zero is extremely important. You know, this is the geographical indicator. You know about geographical indicator. We have tried to do geographical identification of some annual projects. For example, Pochampalli, for example, Silent Fabric, for example, Kanchipuram, or for example, Kutch Embroidery. There are at least 500 items which are unique to India in handlooms and handicraft, jinke geographical indication nahi ho paaye. I was told, in fact, 5 days back by the Uttarakhand government to make an export policy for Uttarakhand. They do not have an export policy for Uttarakhand. They do not know how to go about it. You students, you are the bright people. We are making the geographical indicator for this project. We are making the export policy of Uttarakhand, and we are the one which will lead the region to another. Most of the states do not have export policy because that's not a priority area. And you are the brain behind who can make a policy for such governments. This has not ended. What we call it? Disruption or differentiation. You have to cause differentiation. You have to plan 1-3. What is plan 1-3? Short term, medium term, long term. Short term plan is 1 year, long term is medium term is 2 years, long term is 3 years. In exports, there cannot be a plan which can be more than 3 years old. So make a short term, long term, medium term plan which is not more than 1-3 years. I'm there in this team company of all language students. We call it Eklavya and Arjun approach. What is it? Who was Eklavya? Who was Eklavya? Eklavya was a wheel boy who went to Dronacharya and told him, I want to learn archery. Dronacharya said, I teach archery only to royal children. And do you have money to pay? He said, I do not have money to pay. So what did he do? He made a statue of Dronacharya and he saw what he was teaching to Arjun and he started learning this. So Eklavya approach is best suited to those units which are small and medium, which do not have money to invest in R&D. So what they need to do? They need to follow the leader in their segments. If you follow the leader in the segment and see what are their best practices, you can see Eklavya had almost won till Guru took away his thumb by default. So you know, so even by following the leader, you can be bigger than the actual one. But if you do not want to lose your right thumb, you have to shed your false ego. How will you shed your false ego? By benchmarking in 4 categories, that is product, quality, service, pricing. These 4 are a must when you are following the leader. But I always say Arjuna was the best Dhanurdhar because he represented excellence. So this is best for the medium and large volume exporter who can invest in R&D, follow the Arjuna model. Invest in R&D and reap the benefit. This is the famous story of the thirsty crow. What does he do? Kankar dekhta hai bade mein. You need to have this straw now. You need to update yourself with the modern crow because that is the system today. But when I am talking about be Arjun or be a Eklavya, I do not mean to say ki R&D mein keval invest karne se hi aapka exports bad sakta hai ya aapka business bad sakta hai. The Jugaad model, which is a worldwide accepted model today, is the one where you make lesser investment in R&D, still you get the best benefit. You know our Mangaljan, when we said, the Prime Minister said, Sri Narendra Modi, that the cost was less than a Hollywood movie. And this is the comparative cost of all the expeditions, and this is the cost which is for the Mangaljan, which is so less. Look at all this material. Nano was another Jugaad technology. Look at the water cooler or ultrasound, which is developed by a company like Siemens, or Japanese material pool of Gujarat, where you can keep the entire thing fresh and a cool water. Or this pressure cooker. You know what is coffee maker? Coffee maker ke steam banana karta hai, steam bane sakta hai. Pressure cooker mein steam banta hai, isse wo coffee banata hai. You know, and look at it, such a low cost. Ye basically thrashing ka. This is an incubator car. This is a mobile hospital. You know, the entire Jugaad technology is taught worldwide. There is a book of the Cambridge University on the Jugaad technology. So, we can still do best, and Indians are possibly the best, in terms of low cost and high. So, that's the Jugaad principle. Jugaad principle is that you need to have opportunity in adversity. We do not have money. Do more with less. Be flexible. Include the lowest of the segments, have a passion for it. So Jugaad is a worldwide accepted management technique and it is recognized as an acceptable form of frugal budgeting and R&D at a much lesser cost. Possibly some of you who in fact in IIM you have the incubation cubes, possibly you can develop some of the best Jugaads in the country, which is known.
It was 36 degrees Celsius outside and the sun could not have shone brighter. But in the Asaitona residence in the town of San Pedro, just south of Manila, you'd never guess what time of the day it was. The heat of the summer could be felt inside the house, all right, but none of the sunlight could get in. In every corner of the house, there was just darkness.
Even if you just want to get some water, you'd have to turn on the light.
It had been that way for years, but that's about to change. Demi Bukas and his sons have come to install lights. Not like the electric bulbs they already have, but ones that are cheap, healthy, and energy efficient.
People in this community used to never see the light of day in their homes. But with a soda bottle, water, and simple tools, they never had to live in darkness anymore.
The technology is amazingly simple. All you have to do is fit a metal sheet around a plastic bottle, fill it with water, add chlorine, bore a hole on the roof, insert the bottle, then seal it. And there you have it, 55 watts of clean and free solar light.
This is the light of life. It's really great to be able to see your house and move around without having to turn on the lights during the day.
The genius behind the idea is social entrepreneur Ilak Diaz. Since the project began over a month ago, solar bottle lights have been installed in close to 1,000 households.
It's becoming something that is becoming the new standard of living here. Why should we be trapped in darkness when we can now have the independence to improve our own households with copyable and such a replicable kind of system?
The system not only provides natural lighting, but it breathes new life to plastic bottles that otherwise would have ended up in dumps. It also aims to create so-called green jobs. Demi earns a little over a dollar for every bottle light he installs. Business has been so good that he had to quit his job.
Almost everyone wants to have it. Demand has been so huge that I have to tell others to wait when I run out of materials.
He was also one of the first ones to have solar bottle lights installed in his house. And the savings have been significant.
Before, there were times when we didn't have electricity because we couldn't pay. But with the bottle lights, our electric bill has become more manageable.
If we can use green technologies to save essential pesos, it can go into better things like books, nutrition, and, you know, livelihood.
Ilak hopes to be able to light 1 million homes in the Philippines by next year. And in the future, take it to other developing countries as well. A third world solution to third world problems. Barnaby Lo, CCTV, Manila.
Okay, I'm coming to help by three basic key organizations. Some of you have seen dirty picture. What was the current dialogue of the dirty picture? Yes, filmmakers still was also such as that. Entertainment, or my entertainment too. Mera kehna hai, explores keval teen cheezon se chalta hai. Image, and you have to do the image. Once you have the image, the basic is I, matlab you are one of the exporter. Then I am, you have started, you are one of them. And once you become I am me, then you are the leader. So the journey from I to I am me is a journey where you are stuck in the middle to you develop a clear position. You have a joint venture, and what APJ Abdul Kalam said, you know that dreams are the birthplace for ideas and your ideas. And it's not what you see in sleep, it is the thing which doesn't let you sleep. That's why your idea can live or your idea can die, but the important part is it's up to you that whether you want your ideas to live or your ideas to die. Thank you very much. Technical issues. If there are any questions, then possibly I can go into the technical part of my presentation, including policy, what is the government incentive. I have decided that I'll just aid you, I'll just motivate you, I will just see if I succeed in stoking fire in 20 out of the entire audience. I think my day is made. And I trust me, we are a handholder. I'm leaving behind my card with my mobile number and my email address. Whenever you ask me, even for individual counseling, we are available for that. We will do the counseling, we will hold your hand, we will tell you how to go about it, because that's our job, and we exist because such bright students and entrepreneurs are sitting in front of me. Thank you so much.
So my question is, when the sons are so low on budget, so how do you advise them to go about it? Because they are frugal on the budget, at the same time they follow all the international compliances and they have to export as for the international quality. So is there any government policy in place to support this? Like we have in Startup India plan, they have the startups will be given tax rebates. So are there similar kind of policies in place to support startups for the export scheme?
There are schemes for medium and small scale industries. There are schemes for startups which the present government has just started, and there is a seed money given for that. There are schemes where bank finance is there. There is a scheme where Exim also gives based on the export order which you see. But the important part is how to start a business. You know, you have to open a bank account, which is current account. You have to take import-export code number. You have to place an order, get an order, scrutinize the order, open an LC, submit the documents to the shipping agency, freight forwarder, then possibly you get the export incentive post-export. But that's not important. I always say that it's important that you get 1 or 2 years of experience in the domain where you want to go, then you break away. Most of them, if you see most of them, they have started the company, they had experience, academic experience of 2, 3, 4 years. You know, two things you have to learn. One is that you must learn to quit. That is first principle. Second principle is that when you learn to quit, you have to learn to quit early. You can't wait till 30 years. I'm in the government job because I enjoy being a government servant. I enjoy being a civil servant. Otherwise, I would have quit long back. My background is that I was a student president from Jawaharlal Nehru University and free thinker in it, which is much in name. And I decided that I'm not enjoying politics. So they said, what should I enjoy? I said, okay, I enjoy to be in bureaucracy. And all the experiences which were read out, I almost worked in 16 ministries because after 2 years I feel that I have to do something new to somewhere else. So I move out. Maybe in another 10 days or 15 days I'm again moving out. Now the issue which is important is that you must learn to do it. Now that's point number one. Point number two is that you must see that what is different which you are going to do. Now I give you 100 examples. For example, if you are doing something, let's say handloom work, let's say. Now in handloom, there is a concept called double ikat. You know, double ikat means that on the loom, one person sits here, one person sits there. There are just 4 families which are working in double ikat work. Now if you can have a village adopted where you can train 15 people or 20 people for which government of India will also give you the money, each sari in Indian market costs not less than 9 lakh to 10 lakh rupees. So each sari abroad can cost you, for wherever the ethnic is there, not less than 20 to 25 lakh. Because that's a double ikat work. Now that's one work which is very rare. I'll give you another example. Mashroom. What is mashroom? Mashroom is one, you know, in Islam, the males cannot wear silk. So what do? So in the silk, they give a lining of cotton. So they wear cotton inside and silk is outside. So the silk is not touching the body. Now mushroom work is just coming up. We do not have lots of mushroom work available. Middle East is a thriving market for mushroom work. If we can have a sunrise in the mushroom work, we can have at least 200. I can keep on giving you example. For example, most of the fabrics which we are using for the sari work only. But if we realize that in the fashion wear, if we have the fashion forecast, color forecast, we can go for the product diversification. Go, see what is the trend in the market. The color forecast is there, design forecast is there. Go to the design bank, download some of the designs, convert those fabrics into the design bank and go for the European market. What I am trying to say is that go for a trial order. In the trial order, you should go on a LC basis. Never go and experiment too much in D and DP basis. After that, because you are innovative, that's why I said, there is a famous story of a tortoise and rabbit. You know the famous story. You have heard the story. Kachwa se khargosh jeet gaya because kya fast and steady wins the race. Then the khargosh did dobara usko challenge kiya and khargosh jeet gaya because fast and consistent wins the race. Then third part was the kachwa ne dobara challenge kiya aur usne beech mein river create kar di. To wahan tak gaya fir khargosh ruk gaya. Kachwa river tay karke goal post bahar tha. So you create a river in between. China cannot always compete with you in products where you are changing designs, where it's handmade and where there is something innovative. They can go on repeat this, and today, for the next 15 to 20 years, the trend is that handmade will always be more respected than machine made. So that's why if you can go into the small orders, but there will be high value orders. All create your buying design. The last was खरगोश और कछुआ का क्या था? दोनों में दोस्ती हो गई. लैंड पे खरगोश ने कछुए को रख लिया, जमीन पे कछुआ ने खरगोश के ऊपर रख लिया. So have a kind of what I call is the joint venture. If Chinese products are good in something and you are good in something, you can always have. You know, most of the people like Steve Jobs, when he started joining the dots, you know the famous story of him joining the dots. He says that he created those icons, you know, the face smiling and all. So he says that was never known. So when you have new idea, the moment new idea comes, you will find 50 people running behind you after 2 years. You leave that idea. You are the leader. Go for another new idea. And why today I am lecturing in front of this young generation is that you can always come up with the new ideas. Now, for example, in leather, I can give you, in leather, the moment you go for, you know, the zero discharge facility, which is nowhere in the north, most of it is existing in the south, the immediately your product will go from A to J. In the segment, which is known as saddlery, horses, you are the leader in the market. You know, so you have to find out which is the segment where it's low investment and taking the money, you can emerge as a leader. But the important part which always remains is that never travel the beaten path. Come out with the new idea. In any segment, I can tell you about the engineering items, I can tell you about the handicraft, I can tell you about the leather, I can tell you about the pharmaceuticals, I can tell you about the chemicals. Always go for something when you come and you question yourself, what is it with me which is not there with the rest of the fellows? The moment you find hamare paas ye cheez nahi hai and hamare paas advantage hai, you will emerge as a leader. And if you have an idea, there are 100 people who are willing to finance you. You know, the people willing to come, as professor has rightly pointed out, we are a nation which is bereft of ideas. The moment you come up with good ideas and you say that it's implementable, people will flock to you and tell you that, okay, we are investing here. Banks are there to invest. Small and medium enterprises, the ministry is willing to invest. Microfinance is willing to invest. And the Startup India, the project, the entire, which has started right now, is there with this concept only. That if you have a new idea, innovative idea, you are small, less than 25 crores of turnover, we are there going to be with you. Yeah, go ahead. Yes, you know, there are two things which are very important. Now I'll tell you, for example, when the you know, because you know, the image is built over a long period. It comes with acquisition. That's why there is a brand value. I'll give you a very important, very small example. And that's an actual example. I'm going to give you the example. I was the DC and OSD in Municipal Corporation of Delhi. And I was asked that Commonwealth Games is coming, we need to build a 5-star toilet. My minister called me and said, let's build a 5-star toilet. I said, yes, sir. In all the markets. I said, yes, sir. He said, but I will have no money to pay. I said, very good, sir. Then he said, but I need a 5-star maintenance also. I said, very good, sir. I said, what will we give to the concessionaire in place? He said, I cannot give anything other than that toilet place only. Whatever you want to do, you do it there. I was thinking what to do. I thought about it. I saw a dream that I'm sitting on the roof of the toilet and eating ice cream. That was a dream at early morning. I woke up. I thought, why this dream has come? Then what I did is that I said that all toilets are in the market, which are very prime property. I said, the toilet roof I will give only for eating joints. Now this was an idea which baffled everybody. He said, public toilet ke roof ke koi eating joint kyun set up karega? I said, I will do the marketing. So I went there to this all top McDonald's and Nirula's. I said, pehle toilet kheton mein hota tha, phir ghar ke bahar hone lag gaya, phir aapke bedroom ke saath hone lag gaya. The whole concept of sanitation changed. If you can maintain a toilet there, then possibly we are going to give you free of cost for 30 years to run. But I said, any chain which occupies the place on the top consistent need to have a brand value of not less than 5,000 crores. Why? Because if they do not maintain the toilet, their brand value will be hit. So if they have a stinking toilet below, nobody will come to the McDonald's. So I said that that we will go for a tender where toilet roof will be given to the concessionaire only for the eating joint. Now there was a massive bus, and the rest is the history. But the point which I am trying to tell you is that image if you have to build, you will always come up with ideas. Now for example, phone, today mobile phone, what is it doing? It's serving all the purpose. Now we used to have 10 diseases which used to serve. So you start with something which is serving a useful function. And with that you build up an image. Image does not only mean that you are honest, you have a long-term quality supply. Image also means that you are offering a service which is not being offered by anybody else. You start from there and you offer that service consistently without diminishing the quality. And then as you grow up, you occupy, you can go for merger, you can go for acquisition, and people will flock to you because you always come for innovation. Steve Jobs, when he was picked out of Apple and he set up other two functions, Apple bought both of them and then he again came back to Apple. So the point is, it's your duty. When I'm addressing to all potential businessmen in here, I'm trying to set up something which is new, which is innovative, that will set up in the image, and as you grow, others will join up and will help you in refurbishing, enhancing, and further magnifying the existing image.
Sir, I have a question. You talk about Jugaad innovation, and then you talk about image.
Yes.
So my question is, Jugaad innovation, if you look at it from the international point of view, it does not have quite a good image.
Yeah.
It is something that signifies low quality, something that signifies cheap rather than economical.
Yeah.
So how would you suggest an entrepreneur to leverage, say, Jugaad is synonym for quality?
You know, I saw some ad recently in TV coming up. They said that we are not Jugaad, we are best of the limited. You know, if our Mangalyaan went and achieved the same purpose, did anybody say that because of Jugaad you had less cost, hence it's not praiseworthy? Did it function any less? Yes Bank, Coca-Cola, Siemens, all the multinationals are doing Jugaad. Now Siemens is a German company. That's why I gave you the example of Siemens. When they were portable ultrasound, when they invented, they went by Jugaad technology. In rural areas, Siemens, Jugaad technology, they had a stand. So Jugaad is the one, if you go through the book, the Jugaad, they invented a lamp to keep the homes hot in Britain, and they did not patent it because they said that everybody needs to have that. So most of the Jugaad technology are not patented because it serves a larger function. And Jugaad technology is something, in spite of all people laughing upon, because those who invest very heavily in R&D, they all are running for it. The word Jugaad is basically emanates from that tractor, you know, that scope. But Jugaad is increasingly gaining an international respect. Jugaad may sophistication is a much lower cost. If it serves the function, then the product sophistication, the entire expense is less than 10%. You know, you can make it very, 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 very good looking, and you can make it very, 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 very attractive, and you can patent it. The actual cost, 90%, is in terms of the function which it serves. And once you have the function it serves, then possibly 10% expenses you can make to look very attractive. And trust me, most of the international agencies are going for Jugaad, because with less cost in R&D, if they are achieving the same purpose, possibly that's the best management tool that can be used. And it's not something to be frowned upon. If it's a good idea, the sophistication will come in the passage of time automatically. Yes. Any more? Thank you so much. You have been lovely students, and I enjoyed thoroughly being with you. Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir, for your valuable insights. Now I request the student representatives to present a token of appreciation to our chief speaker, Dr. Amiya Chandra, IIM Rohtak.